Hi folks, Kevin Beasley from New Start Realty and Relocation in Surprise, Arizona, and I wanted to go over the last 6 months' statistics with you guys for sales and rentals here in Surprise only. These are for Surprise only, and this is from 10/3/14 to 4/3/15. So, start out with the sales stats. You know, the market's been real good. You're going to be bumping heads on short sales if you don't come in, you know, at least comps. So have your realtor check the comps. And the thing I don't like about it is that, you know, there's a new law saying that they can't enter, the appraisers can't intermesh, separate rather, REOs, another distressed properties with traditional sales. I don't like that one bit, but so now you have to, when an appraiser does his work, he has to take in distressed property values and make adjustments. And I don't like that because appraisers are appraisers and they're not contractors and they can't come up with a true value, in my opinion. You know, for traditional homes, the prices have gone up, but interest rates are still low. I talked to Cindy Upshaw. She actually wrote one on a buy-down rate for 3%. And so, you know, there's still some good deals out there. However, prices have gone up pretty good. Here's the example on the average closed price in the last 6 months for Surprise. The low, there was one property sold for $22,000, and that was the lowest end. I can imagine what that looked like. And the highest one sold at $850,000. The property that sold for $22,000 listed at $17,500 and sold for $22,000, and then the high end was listed at $899,000 and sold for $850,000. That was about nearly 6,000 square foot home. Now the average sales price within the last 6 months in Surprise has the listed at $212,650. The sold price was $207,918. The average square foot was 2,023 square foot, and the average days on the market was 73. So, if you want more detailed prices, just give me a call and I can, you know, just give me your square foot range and I'll tell you what it's going for. But these are averages. So, like I said, the sales market, it's real good. You know, there's a home around the corner. I wish I'd had the listing, but, you know, it sold in like 12 days for $179,000, and I believe it was, what was that, man? I think it was around 1,800 square foot, and it was a nice home. So, so you can see that these prices have jumped up pretty good here. And Surprise, you know, we're one of the lowest, you know, we had the lowest prices here in the valley, or one of them, besides Queen Creek and Maricopa. But considering all the infrastructure and how cool it is to live here, you know, we are, you know, probably the best price for the buck. Now, I do a lot of rentals, and I'm pounding pavement for them. And within the last 6 months, the average rental listed and sold at $1,143. And that was for a 2,015 square foot, and it was on the market for 32 days. So you can see the rental market's really hot right now. And you got to figure that there's a 2% rental tax on top of that price, too. So, you know, just count on that. Guys, I'm telling you, if if you're looking for a rental in Surprise, give me a call. I'll send you my intake package. And I'll work with you as long as you're willing to take a proactive stance and gather all your documents. you know, I'm bumping heads left and right, especially on nice properties. With pool properties, you know, it's, it kind of puts a bad taste in my mouth in remembrance of the spike in 2008. But, you know, and they're getting a lot more pickier, guys. I mean, you know, there was a few months ago, you know, if you had a job and a decent rental history, I could get you into just about anything. But now, you know, these guys, we're seeing a lot more investor-owned properties. These guys are getting a lot more picky, guys. You know, they're not, so, you know, if you filed a bankruptcy, good. You know, that's probably good. And, because they're not wanting to see a lot of collections on here. You know, if you have pets, you know, they're going to be a little bit more tight on pets, especially cats. These pets, and I don't blame them, you know, to be honest with you. I've seen the results of what happens with a lot of pets. And this $300 that they're charging you for the deposit, non-refundable deposit, isn't really cutting it, you know, and because they're doing a lot of damage. So people, if you get no place, you know, you want to keep your reputation in the rental market, then, you know, make sure that your pets don't tear up the place. And make sure you pay your rent. Because, you know, if you don't do anything else, pay your utilities and your rent. Because these guys are, you know, getting time. Credit rates are going up. Credit scores are going up. You know, people are doing the right thing now, and they know that. And, there are some people, if you don't have a 615 score, they're not even going to look at you. So, just want to let you know, and you're going to be bumping heads. If you find a nice property, you'll like it. My advice is don't delay. You know, let's put it in an app, and hopefully we're not going to, you know, bump heads with other applications. Now, a lot of the people I deal with are real cool. You know, they're going to... you know, they deal with one app at a time. If you meet the basic criteria, of which I'm going to ask you what these same questions that they're going to ask me, and if you answer right, if you meet this criteria, they're going to go ahead and accept you. Brother, and they don't care if another app comes in, the guy makes $30,000 more than you do, you know, they're not going to kick you to the curb. But those are the people I like to deal with. And if you need a credit pull, if you don't know where you're at, you need to know, you can, and you're working with me, you got to sign an agency first, and I'll let you pull your credit on my website. And then you're probably going to have to pull the credit again with another broker, because most brokerages will not accept other brokerages' credit reports. They'll run their own. But mine will, because mine will pull your background. It'll pull your legal background and your civil background, your criminal and civil backgrounds. So sometimes it's wise to find out where you're at instead of waiting until you get into a deal and get your heart set on something. And then you find out, oh, well, I didn't know those guys filed a forcible detainer on me, you know. So that's where we're at. I hope that helps. And if you have any questions, feel free to give me a call, 602-920-2201. Check me out. Check my new website out at newstartrealty.com. And if you need an app, a really cool app, go to my Facebook page at New Start Realty and Relocation, and you can download a really cool app there. So, but my website optimizes automatically to mobile devices, so I think you'll find that helpful. Anyway, the number is 602-920-2201. I wish you guys the best out there, and give me a call or a text or email at any time. Bye-bye.